हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज शिवहरी तिवारी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट स्टैटिस्टिकल हाइपोथेसिस। इट इज़ द इम्पॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग एंड लेट्स मूव फर्दर टू आवर टॉपिक। सो बिफोर मूविंग टू आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक, वी शुड सी व्हाट आर आवर लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिकल हाइपोथेसिस। सो बेसिकली देयर आर सम पॉइंट्स, इट इज व्हाट इज हाइपोथेसिस। इन दिस पॉइंट वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन थ्योरी एंड हाइपोथेसिस, how hypothesis is declared as a theory, truthfulness of hypothesis, and some examples. After that, we will understand the test of hypothesis, how hypothesis get tested, and what are the stages of test of hypothesis. And then we will move further to the definition of a statistical hypothesis. See, here we will also see that what is the importance of statistical hypothesis in machine learning. After that, we will move to the types of statistical hypothesis, that is null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. After that, we will go further to the definition of significance level. What is the importance of significance level? Where significance level is used? And then we will move to statistical decision, where we will check that the calculation of test statistics and how statistical decision is used in a statistical hypothesis. After that, we will study about p-value, and at last we will see how statistical hypothesis is used in our day-to-day life and what is the practical relevance of a statistical hypothesis. So let's move further to our first topic, that is what is hypothesis. So see, basically there are two words, theory and hypothesis. What is theory and what is hypothesis? See, hypothesis is just, we can say, initial state of a theory. If a hypothesis is proved correct, and we can say, if a hypothesis has gone through many tests, study and experimentation, and if the results we have assumed for our hypothesis is correct, then we can say that our hypothesis is correct and it can be proved as a theory. It can be declared as a theory. Now, what are the stages of the hypothesis to make it as a theory? There are many stages. First of all, we have to assume some result before collecting the data. We assume some result that this result should come after the testing of our hypothesis. Then we will collect the relevant data for that hypothesis, and then we will test the data, we will calculate the statistics of the data, and if the result we have got from the test is the same as the result we have assumed before the testing, then we can say that our hypothesis is true and we can declare it as a theory. See, here if the result is not equal to the assumed result, in that case we will check how close is our result to the assumed result. This is called the closeness of the result, or we can say closeness of the test. Now this is how hypothesis is converted to the theory. Let's talk in terms of machine learning. Basically, in machine learning, it states about population parameters, where it concerned about the population of one or more data. So basically, what is population parameter? See, when we are going to test the hypothesis, we collect some data in machine learning, which is known as sample data. If the sample data we have collected is true for our parameter, then we will test the statistics. So basically, in terms of machine learning, the hypothesis is concerned with the parameters of the population. For example, here the example is given. The hospital administrator may want to test the hypothesis that the average length of stay of patients admitted to the hospital is 5 days. Now, how the hospital administrator predict that the average length of the stay of patient admitted to the hospital is 5 days? In that case, first he has assumed that the patients who are admitted to the hospitals, their average length of a stay is five days. After that, he will collect the data of the patients, and then the data has gone through this filtration test, where he will do the process which is called the data pruning. In this process, he will collect the data of the patients who are not seriously injured or seriously ill, or those patients who are not in ICU, and then he will reject the data of those patients who are seriously injured, seriously ill, or who are in the ICU. And then he tests the collected sample data of those patients, and then he will go further to that calculating the statistics. If the calculation of the statistics says that the length of the average length of the stay of all the patients he has that whose data he has collected is more than is equal to 5 days or less than 5 days, only in that case he can say that the average length of the stay of patients admitted to the hospital is 5 days. So this is how we predict the hypothesis. Outside science, a guess or a theory can also be called a hypothesis. Look, here is I am showing you an example. If there is a cloud in the sky, what we are gonna say then? We will say that today it will rain today. But what are the parameters of the rain? It should be, the weather should be humid, the atmosphere should be humid, and there are many other parameters that it should have gone through to prove that the weather is rainy and it will rain today. So basically, a guess or a theory can also be called a hypothesis. This is the definition of a hypothesis. Let's move to our next topic. This is test of hypothesis. Now, what are the stages of testing of hypothesis? How hypothesis is tested? See, the hypothesis testing refers to making an assumption called hypothesis about a population parameter. Like in previous example, we have discussed about the stay or average stay of the patient. The average stay of the patient in a hospital is not more than 5 days. So what is this? Basically, it is an assumption made by the administrator of the hospital, and it is this assumption is called the hypothesis about a population parameter, where population parameter is the patients who are admitted to the hospital. After that, the second stage is collecting sample data, where he will collect the sample data of those patients who are not seriously ill or seriously injured and who are not in ICU. After that, he will calculate the sample statistic, which is the third stage of the testing of hypothesis, and then using that sample statistic he will evaluate the hypothesis, where he will check whether the stay of the average stay of the patient is equal to 5 days or less than 5 days. If the average stay of the patient is more than 5 days, then his hypothesis can be discarded and we can say that average stay of the patient in the hospital is more than 5 days. So here we evaluate the hypothesis in the last stage and we check whether our hypothesis is true or not. So these are the process of the testing of hypothesis, and this whole process is known as the test of hypothesis. To test the validity of our assumption, we determine the difference between the hypothesized parameter and the sample value. So this is how we are doing the test of hypothesis. Let's move further. Now, what is statistical hypothesis? Look, basically, statistical hypothesis is an assertion or conjecture concerning one or more population, an assumption or statement which may or may not be true. See, here we go with both of the condition that if our hypothesis is true, then what will be the result? And if our hypothesis is not true, then what will be the result? See, there is the initial hypothesis, initial assumption, which is known as null hypothesis, and there is another is assumption that is called as alternative hypothesis. If our initial assumption is not true, if our null hypothesis is not true. So in statistical hypothesis, basically the assumption we are making, it can be true or it cannot be true. Both the conditions can happen in statistical hypothesis. Now, here are some examples of a statistical hypothesis. Number one, the average income of all the families in the city is PHP, which is the currency of Philippines, is 36,000, where their assumed mean is 36.00. On the other hand, the alternative hypothesis is saying that average annual income of all the families in the city is not equal to 36,000. So here the mu is not equal to 36,000. Now, in that case, how the person who is testing that the average income of the families in the city is 36,000. In that case, he will go through the data of the people living in some city in Philippines, and he will check what is the average income of all the people of all the families in the city. So in that case, he will check that if the average income of the families in the city in Philippines is equal to 36,000 or less than 36,000, in that case he will say that the average income of the families in the city is equal to 36,000. And on the other hand, in alternative hypothesis, it can be more than 36,000. See, here alternative hypothesis work in both the ways. In some cases, if assumed mean is in, if null hypothesis is not true, that is assumed mean equal to 36,000, and the alternative hypothesis can take the both of the case, that is mu is less than 36,000 and mu is greater than 36,000. So we can assume alternative hypothesis as less than or greater than both of the cases. Here is another example. In this example, it is saying that there is no significant difference between the average life of brand A light bulb and that of brand B light bulbs. Now, how the person who is testing is going to check whether brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb has the same lifespan? So he will not going to check with the one bulb. He will take the data set of many bulbs. He will check. He will use the brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb, and he starts the test on the same day. And if brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb, those both of them dies on the same day, that means there is not much difference between the lifespan of both of the bulb. That means both of the bulbs died on the same day with the difference of 1 minute or 2 minute, or we can say 1 hour, which is very small, that is negligible. Then we can say there is no significant difference between the average life of brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb. Alternative hypothesis is saying that there is a significant difference between the brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb and their average life. So how the person is going to check if the brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb both started on the same day, and if brand B light bulb has the longer lifespan than brand A light bulb, that means its lifespan is more than brand A light bulb, that is more than 1 day or 2 day or 1 week. In that case only we can say that there is a significant difference between the average life of brand A light bulb and brand B light bulb. Another example I have taken, that is the proportion of Metro Manila College who prefer the taste of Pepsi Cola is 2/3, where proportion P equals to, which is assumed mean, is 2/3. On the other hand, the alternative hypothesis is saying the proportion of Metro Manila College students who prefer the taste of Pepsi Cola is less than 2/3. Now forget about Metro Manila College. Take the example of your school canteen. If there are 30 students of in your school, and 20 out of 30 students prefer the Pepsi Cola in canteen over the other brands, then in that case we can say that 2/3 of the students of the college prefer Pepsi Cola. On the other hand, if that proportion is less than 2/3, then we can say that less than 2/3 student of the college prefer Pepsi Cola, and other students prefer some other brand than Pepsi Cola. So these are the examples of statistical hypothesis. Now, what are the type of statistical hypothesis? See, here are two types of statistical hypothesis. Number one is null hypothesis. Basically, null hypothesis is the initial assumption that we are making before we are going to test or collect our data set. So here it is saying it states the hypothesized value of the parameter before sampling. Here it is the statement which says that it states the hypothesized value of parameter before sampling. That means before collecting the sample, we assume some parameter and those assumptions are known as null hypothesis. The assumption we are going to test or we wish to test, or basically we can say these assumptions are meant to be rejected. That means we are going to reject these assumptions in our test, and basically these assumptions are in all the tests, these assumptions are most probably proved wrong. Like population mean mu equals to 20, there is no difference between Coke and Diet Coke. So this is here, like in previous example I have taken H0 and H1. The H0, which is the initial condition that two-third students of the college prefer Pepsi Cola over other brands. So this is the null hypothesis where he is going to test, that is it true that two-third students of the college prefer Pepsi Cola. And if this condition true, then we can say our null hypothesis, our initial hypothesis, can be accepted. But we cannot accept our null hypothesis. I will tell the reason in further slides why we cannot accept the null hypothesis. So what is null hypothesis? Basically the initial condition, like I have said. So it is the assumption that we make before collecting the sample, the assumption we wish to test, or the assumption we are trying to reject. And here is the example that I am telling, that population mean mu equals to 20, there is no difference between Coke and Diet Coke. Okay, let's move further to the another type of statistical hypothesis, which is alternative hypothesis. Now, what is alternative hypothesis? So basically alternative hypothesis tells all possible conditions apart from the null hypothesis. That means the proportion of the students of the college can be less than 2/3, it could be more than 2/3, but it should not equal to 2/3. That's what alternative hypothesis tells us. That means all possible alternatives other than the null hypothesis are called alternative hypothesis. For example, like here it said population mean mu equals to 20, there is no difference between Coke and Diet Coke. Here in alternative hypothesis, mu should not equal to be 20. That means mu can be greater than 20, mu can be less than 20, but mu is not equal to 20, which tells us that there is a significant difference between Coke and Diet Coke. So these are the basic definitions of null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Let's move further. Let's go in detail of null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. So what does null hypothesis represents? The null hypothesis H0 represents a theory that has been put forward either because it is believed to be true or because it is used as a basis for an argument and has not been proven yet. That means a hypothesis, a assumption that we have used as a basis, as a base of an argument to test our theory, to test our hypothesis, that is going to be true, or that is proved, that should be proved to be true, but we haven't proved that true yet. So this is what null hypothesis represents. It is the initial assumptions that we make, like I told you earlier. This is the initial assumptions that we can make before we are going to collect the data and test our statistics and calculate the result. For example, in a clinical trial of new drug, the null hypothesis might be that the new drug is no better on an average than the current drug. Now, how is the drug dealer going to test whether the new drug is better than the current drug? So in that case, he is not going to take the data of the patients who are suffering from the disease, like blood pressure or sugar. He is taking the data of normal patients who are suffering from common cold type disease, and he will test his new drug on those patients if the new drug is working correctly, if there is a difference between the new drug and the current drug. So we could write that H0 is, there is no difference between the new two drugs on an average. In alternative hypothesis HA, is a statement of what statistical hypothesis test is set up to establish. See, in alternative hypothesis is the alternative hypothesis is basically a contradiction of the null hypothesis. That means the alternative hypothesis is here to prove the null hypothesis wrong. That means HA is a, that for example, in the clinical trial of a new drug, the alternative hypothesis might be that the new drug has a different effect on an average compared to the current drug. Now, if the new drug that the drug dealer tested on the patients works treats the patient in 3 days or 2 days, and if the current drug is treating the patient 5 days, or the new drug is treating the patient in 7 days. Look, here we are going to take both of the conditions, that it is less than the null hypothesis or it is greater than the null hypothesis, but it should not be equal to the null hypothesis. So if the drug has treated the patients in less than 5 days, then we can say there is a different effect on the patients on an average. And if drug has treated the patient and it has taken more time than the current drug, in that case also we can say that drug has the different effect on the patient. If it has treated the patient in less days, then we can write our hypothesis that the new drug is better than the current drug on an average. So what will be the result of our hypothesis test? It will be reject H0 in favor of HA, that is, there is no significant difference. That is, there is a significant difference between H0 and HA. Or do not reject H0, that means there is no significant difference between current drug and the new drug. This is what alternative hypothesis proves, and this is what alternative hypothesis represents. Now, what are the steps in hypothesis testing? Look, hypothesis testing has 7 steps. First step is data, where it tells us about the type of data which we are going to take, the sample data, what kind of sample data we are going to take in the testing of hypothesis. Then we are going to test our statistical hypothesis, that is, we are going to take the null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis and prove and going to test which hypothesis is true on the other. Then we will check the test statistics, where we will calculate the test statistics. Then decision rule, we will go for the decision rule, where we will check whether the first hypothesis is true or second hypothesis is true, and then we decide then which hypothesis should be rejected on the others. Then there is a significance rule. Significance rule basically shows us the significance level, which is denoted by alpha, and it is like zero. It is the very very minimal value, and it is like 0.01 or 0.05. That means we are 95 to 99% confident on our result. This is what significance rule is. Then there is a statistical decision, and after that there is a p-value. So what is data basically? Data is the information we have collected from the population parameter. That means there is a population parameter, we have assumed some result, and then we are going to collect the data from some population, from some kind of we can say data warehouse. Now, what kind of data can be taken from population? It could be observation of phenomena, like I have said. For example, we can take, if someone is going to play golf or if someone is going to play tennis, then he will check what kind of weather is suitable for playing tennis or chess or golf. In that case, he will check whether if the weather is overcast, if the weather is humid, windy or hot. And that after that he will observe that what kind of weather is ideal for playing golf or tennis. It could be the result of an experiment, like we have discussed earlier, the result of the testing of our drug. Then it could be a data from a survey, like we have discussed about the patients, the average stay of the patients in a hospital. So the nature, these type of data can be collected for the testing of our hypothesis. The nature of data determines the type of statistical test to be selected. That means the nature of data, that means what kind of data we are selecting, that determines the type of statistical test which we are going to select for further testing. Now, what are test statistics? Test statistics is the statistic computed from the data sample. See, the data we have collected from various places, from many places, and then we are going to compute the statistic from that data. The statistics calculation is known as test statistic. There are many possible values that test statistic can assume. It depends on the sample we have taken from the data. Test statistic is basically the decision maker. And here it is the general formula of the test statistic. That is, the difference between relevant statistics and hypothesized parameter divided by the standard error of relevant statistics. Now, what is decision rule? The decision rule basically tells us basically all possible values that the test statistic can assume are points on the horizontal axis of the graph. See, here is the graph, and it is saying all the possible values that the test statistic can assume are points on the horizontal axis of the graph of the distribution of the test statistic. Here it is the horizontal axis of the graph, and the test statistic, all the possible values are pointing to this point, this axis. So it is divided into two groups. Basically, what are these two groups? The value of rejection region and the value of non-rejection region. This region, where all the possible values points, is called the region which we are going to select, or it is called the non-rejection region. I have denoted as N. And this region, basically. This region is called the rejection region, where all the values lie. If the values lies in these regions, we will reject these values. Now, the decision rule tells us to reject the null hypothesis if the values of the test statistic that we compute from our sample is one of the values in the rejection region. See, if the null hypothesis, the values of the null hypothesis lies in this region, then we basically reject those values. On the other hand, if the values that we have got from our null hypothesis lies in the non-rejection region, that means in this region, then we will select our null hypothesis as our decision. If the computed values of the test statistic is on the values in the non-rejection region, then we will not reject our null hypothesis and we will select it as a decision of our hypothesis. Let's move further. What is significance level? It is the probability of rejecting the true null hypothesis. See, here we calculate the probability that what are the chances that we are going to reject our null hypothesis. The level of significance is a probability value. It decides the decision value that go into the rejection region and non-rejection region. That means it tells the probability of that either we are going to reject our null hypothesis or we are not going to reject our null hypothesis. It is denoted as alpha, and the frequently used alpha value are 0.01 and 0.05. So due to the level of significance, the statistic also called the significance test. We have to make sure that the probability of rejecting true null hypothesis is very small. That if we are going to reject our null hypothesis, that means we should be too much sure that our null hypothesis is not correct and we should reject it. The frequently used alpha values are 0.01 and 0.05. If we select 0.01 as a significance, that means we are 99% sure in our decision, but there is still 1% chance for our decision being false. After that, what is statistical decision? It is the decision of rejecting or not rejecting the null hypothesis. Like I have said, I said earlier, that the significance level tells us the probability of the of the null hypothesis, that we are going to reject it or we are not going to reject it. So that's what the statistical decision tells us. It tells us that we should decide to reject our null hypothesis or we should decide not to reject our null hypothesis. If we reject our null hypothesis, the computed value of the test statistic fall in the rejection region. Like I told you earlier, that if the values of the test statistic, I created a graph like this, and it was the non-rejection region, denoted the red region is the non-rejection region, and other region from that are not red, or we can say the black region, is the rejection region. So if we reject the null hypothesis, the computed value of the test statistic should fall in the rejection region. That means the test statistic result should fall in this region. In that case, we are going to reject our null hypothesis. We will not reject the null hypothesis if computed value fall in the non-rejection region. That means in this red region. If in this region the rejected value fall, if the values fall in this region, the red region, then we are not going to reject our null hypothesis. So what is the conclusion of a statistical decision basically? If we reject our null hypothesis, we should conclude that alternative hypothesis is true. If we fail to reject our null hypothesis, we should conclude that maybe our null hypothesis is true, because we are not going to use the word accepted, because it shows us the type 2 error. Now, when a null hypothesis is not rejected, one should not say that null hypothesis is accepted, like I said earlier. But we say that null hypothesis is not rejected instead. That means we haven't rejected null hypothesis, but we are not going to accept it either. We usually avoid the usage of word accept, because in that case we can have commit error of type 2. Now, what is p-value? The smallest value of alpha, that significance level, that is probability of selecting or rejecting the value of null hypothesis, is known as p-value. That means the smallest value of alpha for which we are going to reject our null hypothesis is called a p-value. Basically, it is the probability that the computed value for a test statistic is at least as extreme as a specified value of the test statistic when the null hypothesis is true. That means the p-value, the probability that the computed value for a test statistics, it should be too much, so much less that it could be neglected by the person who is testing the null hypothesis. In that case, we can say the smallest value of alpha is called the p-value. Now here is a chart of the testing of hypothesis. Here is the sample of the sample data that collected. Then we state the hypothesis. Here we will state the hypothesis. We are going to make assumptions. Then we select the test statistic and then we will calculate it in the next stage. After that comes the part of statistical decision, where we are going to check whether we should select H0 or reject H0, and conclude that H0 may be true, and conclude that HA, that is alternative hypothesis, is true. After that, what are the errors in statistical hypothesis? See, statistical hypothesis, there are two types of error in statistical hypothesis. That is, number one is type 1 error, number two is type 2 error. So what is type 1 error? It refers to the situation when we reject the null hypothesis when it is true. That is, H0 is wrongly rejected. That is, for example, For example, there is no difference between the two drugs on an average. It is the initial hypothesis, or we can say null hypothesis, that we have made on the drugs, on the testing of the drugs. But if we reject this hypothesis, on the other hand, this hypothesis was true, in that case we can do type 1 error. And here type 1 error will occur if we conclude that the two drugs produce the different effects, when actually there isn't a difference between the two drugs. Here the probability of type 1 error is known as the significance level, that is alpha. What are type 2 errors? I told you earlier the type 2 error is basically if we select null hypothesis as true and we use the word accepted, in that case the error that occurs is called the type 2 error. That is, there is no difference between the two drugs on an average is called the type 2 error. That means we have accepted the null hypothesis when it was false hypothesis. Here the probability of type 2 error is shown as beta. After that, what is the practical relevance of statistical hypothesis? See, statistics are helpful in analyzing most of the collection of data. This is equally true of hypothesis testing, which can justify conclusion even when no scientific theory exists. Real world applications of hypothesis testing include testing whether more men than women suffer from nightmares, establishing authorship of documents, that is deep fake algorithms and other things, evaluating effect of the full moon on the behavior, determining the range at which a bat can detect an insect by its echo, deciding whether hospital carpeting results in more infection, select the best means to stop smoking, and testing the claims of handwriting analysis. At last, thank you so much. My name is Shivhari Tiwari. Thank you for watching this video.